going to finish up with a set of reels. The first one is the Emmy Vale reel, yeah. Not too far from here anyway. And we're going to continue on with one of John Egan's. And the last one we don't have a name for, so if anybody knows it, give us a wee shout. So hope you enjoy the rest of the show. You have a great lineup ahead. So yeah, sit back and relax.
What a glorious start. The McKenna family from Clare. I should have introduced myself at the start. Neil Martin is my name, from Belfast, and I was a good friend of Artie's from, I guess, the mid-1980s, and we worked a lot together. And one of the great places to work with Artie was in a recording studio. And there was a great studio in Randallstown in County Antrim, Homestead Recording Studios, and I worked on various projects there with Artie, and it was the first time as well up in Homestead that I met the next man about to join us on the stage, Brenton Quinn. And at that time, Brent was in doing various albums. Mud Wallace owned the studio and engineered it, and we had some of the finest heady days back in the 1980s in that studio. It was terrific, terrific times. And Artie, as you know, worked in show bands as well, and he had a great gra and a great love for all types of music, regardless of the genre. And he had a great gra as well for Brendan Quinn, and many's the session and many's the stage they did share together. They were very, very tight friends. Brendan has with him this evening three of the very finest musicians you would meet on this island or any other island in the world. Rod McVeigh on keyboard, Liam Bradley on drums and percussion, and Nicky Scott on bass. They truly are wondrous musicians, as is Brendan Quinn. And Brendan's most recent recording came out last year, very aptly, Lockdown is the name of the album. So would you please give a big welcome to Brendan Quinn, Rod McVeigh, Liam Bradley, and Nicky Scott. Thank you.
Playing in that big bend in the sky. I keep walking every day, every inch of valley, here and bay. It helps to keep this old body ticking over. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Keep on walking every day. Thank you very much. It's great to be back on the road again, and it's great to be here this night for Arty. I met Arty the first time I met him. Or, no, I didn't meet him. I saw him playing. I was about 16. I had a sister who lived in Coal Island, and this band called the Platters were playing in the parochial hall, and I saw this wee fella playing the guitar, big, huge guitar, and this wee fella behind it. But I could see by him that he was a master. He knew what he was doing. He did all these big bar chords, and he was great. And then I met him when we played relief to Brian Call and the Plattermen in Macherfelt one night. And we were playing, you know, relief, so I met Arty, and was at the Juice Tomb by Brian, and we struck up a relationship, and I learned so much from the man, you know. I'm going to do a song now that by a Belfast singer called Van Morrison, and Arty was a big part of his band for a lot of years. In fact, if you listen to Avalon Sunset, for instance, that album, Arty's guitar is all over that album. So Van thought so much of Arty. Anyway, here we go with Solid Ground. Solid ground, and she shines her light all around. Baby, she moves on the solid ground in the county down. Well, she moves on the solid earth, and she knows just what her wisdom is worth. Baby, she moves on the solid ground in the county down. She lifts me up, she fills my cup when I'm tired and weary, Lord. And she feeds the flame, she gives me hope to carry on. Say hello. But she's someone I really know. Cause when I was young, she made me roam far from my home. Robin Gray in the county down. Thank you. carry on. If you see her, say hello. 'Cause she's someone I really know. You know, when I was young, she made me roam far from my home. Far from my home. Kind of down. She made me roam far from my home in the county town on the summer ground. This next one is a song by J.J. Keel. Artie would have been a big fan of J.J. Keel's. In fact, he produced this track, actually, for me way back in 2007. Rod was on it. Liam was on it. I don't think you were there. I think he was there. The song called Ride the River. You know the day is slowly fading. I've been waiting now forever for this ride. Right. You gotta ride the river in this boat. Ride the river. Ride the river in this boat. Ride the river. Ride the river in this boat. Ride the riding river. You got to ride the river. Come on, Rod, one time. Rod McGlynn. My God, thank you very much, folks. I'm going to leave you now with a song written by the great John Prine. Artie produced this for me as well. And I kind of changed the words a wee bit to suit our part of the world here. You feel like singing, you've got good, you're clapping well there, but do you feel like helping me out here with the chorus? What do you think? It's very easy, you know. It goes like this. Glory, 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 glory. You can never get enough. Time alone will tell the story of the glory of true love. Could you sing that, do you think? Come on, try it. Glory, glory, glory. You can never get only time of the glory. I'll give you a shout in about 3 minutes, all right? Oh, the glory of true love is a wild and precious thing. You don't grow no magnolia or only blossom in the spring. Know the glory of true love, zip will last your whole life through. Never will go out of fashion, always will loot on you. Can climb the highest mountain, touch the moon and stars above, but a faithful just fountain, virtue the glory of true love. Jerome. Show. You can give them all the good will, for the glory of true love. And you can climb the highest mountain, touch the moon and stars above. But oh, faithful is just a fountain, virtue, the glory of true love. You have to help me out here, come on. Glory, 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 glory. Everybody, you can never. You can. Only time. Of the glory of true love. One more time. Glory, 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 glory. Tell the story of the glory of true love. True love. A big hand for the band. A big hand for the band.
For Brendan Quinn. Big hand for Brendan Quinn. BQ.
The extraordinary Brendan Quinn, and Jerome McGlynn didn't lick it up off the street now. It's hugely impressive. An inordinately important part, of course, of Arty's life was his marriage with Nollig, and Nollig Casey is one of the most exemplary fiddle players to come out of this island. She's from Bandon, near Bandon in County Cork. And I'm really looking forward. A few of us are going to play a few tunes with Nollig now. Could you please welcome Nollig Casey?
Hello, everybody. Delighted to be here and remembering Arty in this way, and hope you're enjoying the night. Myself, Neil, Rod and Jerome are going to do a set for you now. We're going to start off with a hornpipe that was written by a great musician from West Cork called Pat Crowley, and it's called The Harp and Shamrock. And the second tune is a tune that I wrote, and it's called The Silver Strand. So this was a set that myself and Arty enjoyed playing together a lot. So here we go.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We'll continue now with a slow air. It's a lovely old air that I got from an old manuscript collection, and it comes from my part of the country, West Cork. It was collected in Clonakilty in the early 19th century, and myself and Arty recorded this on our first duo album, Lead the Knave. So it's called Cape Clear. Thank you very much. A quick set of reels now, and this is another set that myself and Arty recorded on the Lead the Knave album. And I forgot to mention actually that Neil played cello on the Lead the Knave album as well. So the first one Three Wheels, the first one is called, what's it called? Anyway, oh, Leatherburns. Leatherburns. The second one is The Cottage in the Grove, and the third one is called Derry Craigwood. Near where I grew up in West Cork, and it means the fort of the Fairy Queen. And again, this was a favourite tune that myself and Artie used to play together. and we recorded it actually on the Causeway album. And Rod, you were involved in the Causeway, weren't you? And I can't can't remember if you were or not, but a lot of people were in there. So anyway, this is it. It's called List the Ban Reina, or Fort of the Fairy Queen. Thank you. We've just been joined by the fantastic drummer and percussion player, Liam Bradley. So we're going to play a tune now that comes from northern Spain. It's a Galicia tune. And again, it's a tune that was a favourite of myself and Arty when we did our gigs. And we recorded this on one of our albums called The Music of What Happened. So here it is. It's called Jota de Maya.
Thank you.
Thank you. So we're going to welcome on the stage two of the finest fiddle players you will ever hear, and they're from County Tyrone. Please welcome on stage to join us. Actually, it's not until the second next June. So.
And they're not from Tyrone. They're from Mayo.
No, Cathal and Stevie Hayden. They're waiting in the wings, but it's not the next tune actually. So the next tune we're going to play is a tune that was composed by Arty. And he called it the Cranman, after an old uncle of his, or a granduncle maybe, that came from a part of the country near Omagh called the Cran. So we have two more people joining us here. The wonderful Nikki Scott and Omagh's own Eamon McElhone. Great guitar player. Just to say that this next selection is this is from Arty's last album that he did in 2018 called Butira, and Butira was the little townland that he came from near Omagh. So this tune is from Butira, and we'll be following it with others. Thank you very much. We're going to follow that with a tune that myself and Arty recorded on our 1995 album, Causeway. And this was the title track. So it was actually a melody that I wrote, and Arty heard it and did all kinds of amazing things with it, and arranged it and orchestrated it. And did wonderful things to it. So it's called, actually, no, I'm talking about the wrong tune. I'll tell you what the name of that is in a minute. But this next tune actually is a tune that Artie composed, and again, it's on the Causeway album, and the drummer on the album actually deserves a mention. Do you want to, Joe?
An old friend of most of us here tonight, and fabulous drummer, sadly missed, and God bless him. And also a special word for another great Omagh musician and another great friend, Eddie McLaughlin.
So this is Jack Palance's, and we're joined on stage by the fantastic Stevie and Cathal Hayden. Tune. It's a Mexican tune, as far as I know, and Artie recorded it on his Butira album. It's a beautiful tune called Amapola.
One, two, three, four.
We're going to finish the first half of the concert now with this next tune, and this is the title track of our Myself and Arty's Causeway album, and as I said, it was a melody that I wrote and Arty arranged and orchestrated it, so it's a great arrangement, I think. It's called Causeway.
Welcome back to Act Two, and I hope you all got lashings of hot tea and sticky buns to sustain you. Four extraordinary local musicians now. Paul McGlinchey on flute, a great friend of Artie's, and was also his doctor. And Paul was the All-Ireland Senior Flute Champion for three consecutive years in the early to mid-1990s. And one of his initial, very interestingly, one of his initial big musical influences was Arthur Kearney, Artie's uncle. And they produced a great CD together, The Boys of the Town. Along with Paul is Shane McAleer, very well known around these corners. And Shane, also an All-Ireland champion. He played fiddle with Dervish for the first clatter years. He's worked with Paul Brady, with Christy Moore, with the Dubliners, Sinead O'Connor as well. And along with them is Eamon McElhone, I beg your pardon, whom you also know. And I didn't know this until I was reading up about the gig earlier this week, that Eamon won the John Lennon Songwriting Award while still a student at college. I mean, holy God. That's kind of impressive. And Eamon has worked along with Stockton's Wing and Solas and Fluke and Cara Dillon. He's toured the world many times over. He's been all around this globe, and he's composed music as well. And with him tonight is a local man on bouzouki and guitar, Ryan O'Donnell. And these four people really epitomise the strength and the power of very serious traditional music around this part of the world. Would you please welcome this quartet on?
All doing? You can hear me talking all right without using another mic, yeah? Okay, yeah. I have a great loud voice like that. Right, we're going to start off with a couple of marches here. The first one is called the Pikeman's March, and the second one is called Down the Glen, Huas a Glenna. And I recorded these with Eamon a few years ago there, so none of them are actually in march time at all. The first one's slow and the second one's fast, so it's just typically awkward. Thank you. quit standing up in a long time. Hips are feeling it. I can't dance either. I was just going to tell you a story about Artie, a quick story there. I was actually down at Ryan's wedding here, and I was doing groomsman, and Ryan's sister was one of the bridesmaids. And actually, Brent and Quinn's band were playing. And it was the first dance anyway, and I hadn't a clue what to do, and she had even less of a clue what to do, so we were just doing this kind of cracking with each other. I sort of could feel this glare, somebody staring at me, and I looked over, and Artie was sitting down over here. I just seen him, he went like this. And I came over, and he was sitting down, like, "You resemble a condemned building." So that's the crack. We play a couple of hornpipes now for you. Thank you. they like the hornpipes? Do we play more?
No. Do you know any more?
A few, yeah. That's great here. It's a great honour to be here tonight to honour Artie's memory. And are you all having a good night? You enjoyed the first half anyway? Yeah. It's
all downhill from here.
From up, yeah. Yeah, that's right. But yeah, we've only all got a few minutes each, so we're going to finish off with three reels here. The first one I wrote myself, it's called After What You Can Nearly See It From Here, the Camoan River. So it's called the Camoan. The second tune is called The Swallow's Tail. And the third tune is called The Raveled Hank of Yarn, which you wouldn't want to say that after a few pints. Thank you.
Fantastic, fantastic, energetic music there. Despite all that he did and all of the dizzy heights that he achieved, Arty never forgot the raw bar, that honest and true root of traditional music. It was everything to him. And I think that that core belief is central to the solid, earthy and genuine music of two Trillick brothers who are coming on now, John and Connor Woods, and Ryan O'Donnell is going to join them again. And Connor was just telling me now that 10 days before he died, that Arty did a gig in Trillick with Connor. I thought that was such a very poignant thing to hear, and that it'll come to no great shock. Arty was playing a dream, as always. So would you please welcome John and Connor Woods, and again, Ryan O'Donnell. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks very much. That was two jigs there. The first one was called Contentment is Wealth, and the second one was the Donnybrook Fair. I'm going to play a wee lament. I'll only play it over once, but I played it for Artie on the last gig that, well, that he done, but that we done, and it was only about 10 days before he passed away. And he seemed to like it, so I'm going to give it a wee go here now. So thanks very much. It's called The Lament for Limerick. Thanks very much. We're going to finish up now with two reels, but before we go, we'd like to thank Jerome and Nullag and everybody for asking us here. Artie was an awful lot more than just a guitar player. He was somebody that inspired everybody that he met, everybody young and old. You could learn something from Artie McGlynn, and we were privileged to know him and privileged to play music with him. So thanks very much. Thank you.
Beautiful, genuine, heartfelt, warm music there. Really wonderful. Mark McCausland, singer-songwriter, you know him. He's from here. One half of the Lost Brothers. And I think of that beautiful version of Carina, Carina that I heard. Just such a way to tell a story. I think Mark is a true craftsman, and his ability to shape and share memorable songs and tunes is to die for. He tells the story without fuss. And in many ways, that was Artie's way of going to, let's just hear the thing, don't clutter it, don't mess with it too much. Would you please welcome Mark McCausland.
This is the 4-star.
Excellent.
That was a Chet Atkins tune called Warm and Windy. I used to talk to Artie about Chet Atkins, and I think he met him once actually. Had breakfast with him in Nashville. He told me a story about it. It was a really interesting story, but I was always drunk when he told me it, so I wish I could tell you. It was a good story though. It involved breakfast, Chet Atkins, bacon, eggs. But I always loved his open tuning, Artie. Dad Gad and Mad Lad and Sad Dad. And this one's in Dad Fad. But it's a John Fahey tune. I think he recorded it in 1963. It's called Red Pony. Get Jerome up for a tune. Remember the last time I was in New York? It was weird. We got, for some weird reason, we got invited to like Bob Dylan's like office to meet his manager. I don't know why. His manager didn't know why we were there, and we didn't know why we were there. It was really awkward. But we had like this like hour meeting with him, and we kind of just sat looking at each other for a while and going, who set this up? And it was kind of awkward. But what broke the ice was I mentioned where I was from, and he says, "Oh, you must know Arty McGlynn." And then I was like, "Yeah, do you know him?" And he's like, "Bob is a massive, massive fan of McGlynn's fancy." That's like. So that really broke the ice. And then the secretary, the lovely guy called David, came running in and he goes, "Oh, who's that?" And he looked it up immediately. And was, he was blown away. He went home that night and we met him the next day. And he was a guitar player as well, this Dave guy. And he sat up all night learning the whole album. I only ever learned one tune of it though. I think we'll play it now.
Do you want to do Blackbird?
Yeah.
Yeah.
tune we used to play every week or so in McCann's under the guise of, we had many a band name, but I think we went with the Regrets in the end. It was Artie's favorite. Okay, so I'll see you in my dreams. Finish up with this one. Artie loved playing the song. It was our hit. the big one. For Artie, Cannonball Rag. Thank you.
you.
Mark McCausland and Jerome, of course. What a presence Jerome McGlynn has been here this evening, and it's so glorious to hear the legacy continued. Really beautiful, really beautiful. The last kind of official act, as it were, of this evening are in the wings. At least they should be in the wings. You wouldn't know with some of them now. When I think of the music that these three men create, certain words come to mind, words like wild, impassioned, fiery, dazzling, forces of nature, unstoppable. Yeah. Exciting, pulse-rising, and masterful. Would you please welcome Cahill and Stephen Hayden and Jennifer Lupari.
I think Nigel has done a great job this tonight, so a round of applause for Nigel Martin.
How you all doing? Great Nigel's music, wasn't it? Fantastic. We're going to put an end to that. Start off a few reels. This first tune is great old tune called the Silver Spear or Spire or something like that. And then there's the G tune, which has no name in my head, and a third one. So let's see. Thank you. every time I produced the banjo when Arty was around, he would always refer to it as the old frying pan. There's the old frying pan. Would you show your appreciation for the great sound all night from Anda up here? It's also a way of seeing Anda give us a little more banjo on the monitor. Thank you. Thank you.
Cal's getting the fiddle ready. Another Omagh man that is responsible for my downfall, as well as Mr. McGlynn, was the great journalist who wrote the song, The Bowron Rap. Do you remember that? It haunted me for years.
It's still haunting me.
Neil Johnson and I, when we were training for the Olympics, Cultural Olympics, this was recorded in Antrim, Arantestown, on Good Friday. And at that time on Good Friday, you could either make music or go to Mass. So this was recorded on Good Friday. But we're not going to play that because it's. I'm just marking it as a respect for Artie and... Neil, Cal's gonna. Sorry, Cal. Here you are. No, take it. Oh, you've another. Cal's one of his own.
The unbelievable, wonderful Gino Lapari.
What do you mean unbelievable?
Just you're unbelievable. In every sense of the word.
I decided to wear a waistcoat and a cravat because Artie would love that. He would be laughing now. Just.
I think this man needs another round of applause. He's been on off the stage all night. Jerome McGlynn here. Unreal. Unbelievable. We're going to finish off our bit here now with myself and Stephen's version of a lovely song called The Mountains of Pomroy. And we're going to play a few reels after it, and we're going to get some help with Shane and Eamon and Paul. And anybody that knows these tunes, come on ahead, on, sure.
Come on ahead.
We'll get to.
Forget to wear your mask.
I was just saying to Neil there earlier that it's about 42 or 43 years ago, I went into the studio with Artie to make an album called Hand It Down, and that's 42 years ago, to roughly, yeah. It's a long time. Thank you.
Well, what an extraordinary evening, and hasn't it been great for all of us and for all of you to celebrate Arty McGlynn this evening? An extraordinary man and an extraordinary legacy. We're all going to finish off with a tune now that Arty introduced to this island and to the world of traditional music. An English band, the Penguin Cafe Orchestra, and this is Tune for a Found Harmonium. Ihiwai Goramila Moyagovas Event Shop.
Thanks again. A few reels just.